Continuing coverage of the death of Bishop Joseph McFadden. The head of the Harrisburg Diocese died this morning. Here's some of the bishop's background. He was born in 1947 in Philadelphia. After graduating from high school, he went to St. Joseph University, where he majored in political science. McFadden was a teacher before entering the seminary in 1976. McFadden was ordained as a deacon in 1980 and as a priest a year later. He was the president of Cardinal O'Hara High School in Springfield before becoming Bishop of Harrisburg in 2010.
No matter what role he played, Bishop McFadden was committed to people who needed to help the most. News 8's Matt Barcaro continues our team coverage on the legacy of Bishop McFadden. Matt.
Ron, it was not uncommon to find Bishop McFadden at a benefit for a Catholic charity. He especially liked the golf outings, but he also visited homeless shelters and homes for those living with HIV. And as we found out today, you didn't even have to be Catholic. The bishop just wanted to help you.
As the head of Catholic Charities in the Harrisburg Diocese, Mark Totero knew he could always count on Bishop McFadden.
You know, he looked at anybody as a human being. And a human person, you know, in need. So we serve the needs of anybody that came to us.
So when these flowers and a card addressed to the bishop showed up at the diocese office, Totero wasn't surprised. But how the bishop helped the person who sent them was a surprise. Sergei Akimov was about to give up. The sewer line at his house backed up so badly neither he, his wife, nor his three children could use the water. He looked everywhere for help, says some churches turned him away, but through his broken English, he talked to a random man he stopped in the Harrisburg Diocese parking lot.
I don't know who this is. I think if I know who this is, probably I walk away.
Sergei is not Catholic and had no idea that man was Bishop McFadden. But just between the two of them, Sergei says McFadden gave him more than $1,000 of his own money to fix the sewer and didn't tell anyone he did it.
I begin to ask what is my problem. He looks like knows my problem, like an angel.
Later, Sergei went back to the angel. His house was falling into foreclosure, and again, he got help. He says the bishop straightened out his paperwork and is in the process of saving Sergei's house. It was Sergei who sent the flowers, and on the card he wrote that he and his family will praise the Lord for the help they got.
I keep in my heart for all my life.
He says he will forever be grateful for Bishop McFadden, who helped him when no one else would.
Wondering, Bishop McFadden did see the flowers and cards before he left for that conference in Philadelphia earlier this week. Ron.
Talk about the ultimate testimony of helping others. Mm-hmm. All right, thank you. News 8's Matt Barcaro live tonight.